In today's video, I want to showcase my favorite warm florals. So if you are anything like me, you probably wear your florals all year round. Today, I do want to concentrate on my warm florals only because around this time of year, when it starts to get a little bit cooler outside, this is kind of what I crave. This is kind of what I reach for. I'm kind of particular and I'm very specific when it comes down to my warm florals, because even though I like them to be warm, I still like them to be clean. Like, am I the only one? I like a warm floral, but it still needs to be clean and fresh. I need that aspect for me to really enjoy it. All these fragrances on this list are strikingly beautiful. They're addictive, they're intoxicating. I mean, some of them are downright intriguing. Like, I have a full list here. If you don't follow my channel, I'm gonna put it out there right now. So I'm one of those people, like, I'm not too much into modern fragrances. Like, I wear them and I do enjoy them, but this list is gonna be unlike the kind of lists that you typically see. And I'm not saying that like, oh, I'm trying to boast or anything, like I'm special, because I don't think so. I'm not trying to say that, but like I'm very specific with my florals. I like beautiful florals, and if you ask me, some of the most beautiful florals came out back in the day. Like, they're not making florals like these anymore, and I love to smell feminine, I love to smell pretty, and most of all, I like to smell unique. I don't want to smell like everything else that's on the Macy's counter right now. I do wear those, but if I'm being honest, my favorites are like classics. So that's pretty much what you're gonna see. If that's not your kind of thing, this video may not be for you. Of course, you know how I do on my channel. I like to keep the fragrances that I talk about budget friendly. So all these fragrances are coming in under 40 bucks, and a lot of them are coming in way under that. So I hope you guys appreciate that. Anyway, guys, if you wanna see my picks, just keep watching. Welcome back, and thank you so much for joining me. As promised, I'm gonna be showing you guys my favorite warm florals. Let's jump right into this list. So the first fragrance that I have on this list is actually my scent of the day, and it's a classic from the house of Calvin Klein, and this one is called Contradiction. This one was launched in 1997, and even though it was launched in 1997, it really doesn't have a dated smell or anything like that. It smells like, in my opinion, it smells modern. It has a modern, chic, classy feel to it, so you don't have to worry about it smelling old or old-fashioned or anything like that, because I know a lot of people don't like smells like that, including myself. Like, I don't want to date myself by wearing like an older perfume. So as I'm sitting here, what I'm getting is a fresh, clean, airy floral scent, a tinge of clean laundry freshness. It smells so good. I'm getting a bit of a like fizziness, almost like Coke, like Coca-Cola. I'm getting like that type of fizziness to it. I know that's kind of strange, but that's what I'm getting. So it's a very complex scent. It has a lot of layers to it, but I think it's so well done. It is beautiful. I just love this scent. It smells so good. Now, what I wish someone had told me, which is what I'm gonna tell you guys, is to not be intimidated. Don't be intimidated by the ensemble, by this clunky chrome cylindric cap and the amber juice, because I think that's what kind of kept me away from this fragrance for so many years. I was so scared to try this fragrance because of the appearance. I just thought it was gonna be some weird, smelly, strong perfume. I don't know why I thought that, but because of the way it looks, I thought that's what I was gonna get. But instead, I got the opposite. This is feminine. It's clean, fresh, airy, a little sweet, a little fizzy. It smells so good. Another tip that I'm also gonna give you guys is to spray liberally with this one, because it is a lighter scent. By the looks of it, you would think that it's strong, it's overpowering, but it's kind of hard to overdo this fragrance. So be quite liberal if you want this one to last and if you want it to really project. So that's my tip for this fragrance. This is a beautiful scent. Definitely try this one out. Very inexpensive, so you don't really have a lot to lose. It's a gorgeous scent, let me tell you. Classy, modern, chic. And because of this whole look that I have going on today, that's the reason why I decided to wear this scent. This is Contradiction. It's from the house of Calvin Klein. Up next is Prada La Femme. This is of course from the house of Prada. So originally I was gonna have this one be my scent of the day before deciding on my Calvin Klein, because I feel as though I wanted something that was very chic, very fresh, clean, classic. I just wanted that type of fragrance today, and I think Prada La Femme has that kind of scent. When I smell this fragrance, I get a clean, fresh, soapy vibe from it, but it's also a little sweet and it's also a little bit warm, especially on the dry down. So the dominant notes in this one are tiare flower and tuberose. So those are the main two florals that I get. There's beeswax in this one. The beeswax to me is not prominent. There's a little bit of a beeswax essence. I'm not getting anything like overly sweet. I'm just getting a light sweetness, and I guess that's coming in from the beeswax. For the most part, what I get when I wear this fragrance is a classy, classic bar of white soap. What I love about this is that added warmth, that sweetness that you get in the base. I think it kind of sets it apart from your typical soapy fragrance. I'm satisfied with the performance of this one. I think the sillage and the longevity is buildable, so it depends on how much you spray on, which I think is a good thing. So if you don't want it to be overpowering, you could give yourself a couple of sprays. If you want it to be a little bit louder, you could just go ahead and spray some more. If you're like me and you're looking for a soapy fragrance that's actually a little bit warm, this is your pick right here. So this is a Prada La Femme, and this is from the house of Prada. Next is the Modern Muse, and this is from the house of Estee Lauder. This fragrance is fairly new to my collection, but I've been really enjoying it. I think it has an amazing scent. It just smells so good. From the first blast to the last breath of this fragrance, I enjoy it. This is all about jasmine. You get a slight sweetness from the honeysuckle, and we have the most beautiful creamy musk in the base. It does remind me of Narciso Rodriguez For Her. So if you like that fragrance, I could guarantee you're gonna like this one, because they do have the same kind of scent, especially when it dries down. I think this is gorgeous, and if you want to own this fragrance, take advantage of the link that I have in my description box, because right now, if you're okay with just owning the 1 ounce bottle, you can get this for only $15 on Amazon, and I have the link below. Just saying, this is a fragrance that used to be super expensive. Not sure why it's so discounted, but who cares? This is a beautiful scent. Definitely try this one out. It's called Modern Muse, and it's by Estee Lauder. Longevity and sillage is good on this one, so no worries with that. Beautiful scent. Up next is another fragrance from the house of Estee Lauder, and this one is called Pleasures Intense. So I'm just gonna say this right now. This fragrance is not for everyone. Not everyone is gonna like this scent. It is very, very unique. I've never smelled anything like this, but I thoroughly enjoy this scent. When I tell you I love this scent, I love this scent, especially once the fragrance gets a chance to dry on the skin. That's when the real beauty of this fragrance comes out. This is basically a fresh bouquet of lilies, peony, jasmine, steeped in maple, vanilla, and benzoin. I know that sounds weird, and I know it sounds off-putting, but it just works. So if you're up to the challenge, definitely try this fragrance out. I was contemplating on whether or not I should add this fragrance to this list, because the deal that I saw was in store. So if you are fortunate enough to have access to Burlington or TJ Maxx or any of those department stores, you may see this on the shelves right now going for around $35, which is a steal, to be honest, because this perfume is not like cheap perfume or anything like that. Online, the prices are a little bit, normal for what the perfume is, but if you could find this one in store, definitely take advantage of that. It's a beautiful scent, but like I said, it's very unique, but I absolutely love this one. The sillage and longevity on this one is excellent. So if you see this fragrance around and about near department store, definitely try this one out. Of course, only try this one if it sounds like something that you'd enjoy. Up next on this list is a classic. It's beautiful. This is from the house of Elizabeth Arden, and this one is called Fifth Avenue. I love this scent. I slept on this one for so many years because I just felt like maybe it wouldn't be a scent that I would enjoy. Thought it was gonna smell a little dated, and I just didn't think I would like it. This is another fragrance where the packaging is just so misleading. It makes you think it's gonna be something old school or fashion, and that's just not what this fragrance is all about. Now, don't get me wrong, it's a classy, classic fragrance. Like, they don't make fragrances like this one anymore, but I still think the packaging is a little bit misleading. I don't know, I just think the whole packaging just doesn't match what the fragrance smells like. So even though this is a very clean, fresh, pristine fragrance, there's a slightly sweet warmth to this one. The dominant notes in this are lemon blossom, and we also have lilies in this one. So it's pretty much a white floral scent, very clean, has a little bit of a soapy smell, but not too heavy on the soap. But it's definitely clean, it's definitely fresh, it smells classy and classic, smells quite bougie. I think the name Fifth Avenue is very fitting. For those of you guys who don't know, Fifth Avenue in New York City is like this iconic avenue where they have like a lot of expensive shops, and you know, everything expensive is on Fifth Avenue, okay? The rich folks be hanging out over at Fifth Avenue, okay? So basically that's what the name is all about. But if you're looking for a classic, beautiful, fresh, clean floral with a little bit of warmth, a little bit of powderiness, just something under all that clean freshness, definitely look into Fifth Avenue by Elizabeth Arden. It is a classic and it's a must try. It's a beautiful scent. You could be liberal with this one because I think it's like light. It's not a fragrance that is overpowering or strong or anything like that. So I think, you know, you could go a little bit heavy-handed with this one. Be strategic with how you spray it, and you could definitely get it to last. This is a beautiful scent. I love this one. Up next is a Tuberose Mystique, and this is from the house of Bulgari, and this is from their Splendida line. This fragrance is for those of you guys who definitely enjoy a good tuberose scent, especially the bubblegum kind, because there are different types of tuberose. You have buttery tuberose, you have green smelling tuberose, and you have this kind where it smells kind of like bubblegum. So if you like the bubblegum type, this is definitely for you. So it is sweet, bubblegummy. Now, what's unique about this one is that it does have a myrrh note to it, which gives it like a warm spiciness under all that bubblegummy sweetness. Even though I'm describing this one as bubblegummy, don't get it wrong, don't get it twisted. This is a classy scent. It smells really, really good. Definitely try this one out. Another one that you could just go heavy on the sprayer because it's a light fragrance, but the sillage and the longevity is buildable. So you could just go ahead, spray a little bit heavy in order to get this one to last, especially on days where it's going to be cold and the fragrance may get a little bit lost. So this one is Tuberose Mystique, and it's from the house of Bulgari. Up next is Miracle by Lancome. I already told you guys I'm into the classics, so this is yet another classic. This is from the house of Lancome. This fragrance has been in my collection for so many years. I've been through bottles of this one. This fragrance was my signature back in the early 2000s when I was a freshman in college. I really like this one. I like how it kind of like transforms like throughout the day. The dominant notes that you get when you spray this one out is that beautiful lychee smell. I think this is the fragrance that introduced me to lychee. So you get that fruity tart smell along with the freesia that gives you a little bit of a soapy vibe, and the ginger that gives you that fizziness. So the opening is just amazing. When it dries down, it does get a little bit warmer, and that's where it's so surprising because it kind of really transforms once the fragrance has been on your skin for a little bit of time. So the amber comes in and the musk come in, making the fragrance a little bit warmer. It just smells so amazing once the fragrance dries down. I mean, everything about this fragrance is just so impressive, from the opening to the heart to the base of the fragrance is just so amazing. It does have that classy feel to it too, like this doesn't smell cheap or anything like that. It's called Miracle, and it's from the house of Lancome. Up next on this list is Burberry Body EDT, and this one is the EDP. Now, I brought two to the table because it's hard to choose one over the other. It's just gonna depend on your personal taste and what it is you're looking for in a fragrance. The dominant notes in both fragrances are rose, vanilla, peach, and wormwood. So those are the dominant notes. So it does give this clean, fresh, floral scent. It's of course fruity from the peach. The wormwood gives it like a very strong herbal type scent, so you have to be into that. The wormwood is very unique. I don't think I've ever smelt it in another fragrance. Now, obviously, I made a dent into this one, so I have more experience wearing this one. And I could tell you this much, it is a strong fragrance. And to make a dent into this perfume is saying a lot, because it's not easy to make a dent into a fragrance this strong, because two or three sprays is all you need to just be good for the whole day. That's not to say that this fragrance is not long-lasting or that it has like a malsillage. It's still a very powerful scent. It's just not as strong and tenacious as this one. But I think if you're looking for a classy fragrance that is clean and woody and musky and a little bit powdery, you'll definitely like this fragrance. But it is very unique and I think it's worth trying. I would say try the EDT first, and if you like it and you think you could handle something a little bit stronger, then you can move on to the EDP. I usually wear this one when I'm going into the office, when I'm like very dressed up, you know, Monday morning, crisp, sharp, you know, you're putting your best foot forward. It has that kind of scent. It's not a really floral type of scent. It's not that kind of scent. It does have a serious, no nonsense, no frill type of scent, but I really do like it. It's a beautiful scent. So next up on this list is My Name, and this is by Trisardi. I would say of all the fragrances on this list, this has to be the most intimate scent. I think it wears very close to the skin, and I think it's meant to be a skin scent, but that's not to say that it doesn't perform well, because when you're wearing this, you're able to smell it. You'll definitely feel it around you. It's just not a fragrance that is loud. I don't think it's meant to be loud, but you could definitely feel it. You definitely feel the presence, and you will even get compliments. I get complimented wearing this fragrance. This is Violet. We have Lilac, we have Heliotrope, we have some vanilla and musk. It's a very delicate scent. It's very calming. I could see someone enjoying wearing this one to bed because it just has that intimate, delicate type of scent. I think it's beautiful. I especially love the dry down. I love the musk that they use in here. Not sure what kind of musk they use, but it smells so sensual. It just smells so beautiful. I don't want to call this fragrance sexy, but it does have a quiet sexiness to it. I love the scent of lilacs, and you get that beautiful lilac note in here. It is beautiful. This is My Name, and it's by Trisardi. Next is Just Cavalli, and this is from the house of Roberto Cavalli. So every time I speak about this fragrance, I always question myself. I'm like, should I talk about this scent? Because it's one of those fragrances that it's not gonna appeal to everyone, okay? Because it's very unique. I know when I first experienced this fragrance, I was like, what the hell is this? Like, what did I get myself into? And it took me a good couple of years to get to the point where now I could talk to you guys about it and even recommend it to you guys. But I must admit, it is a unique scent and it's not gonna be for everyone. Immediately when I smell this one, I get a white floral scent that is kind of scratchy, and right after I get a pink bubblegum smell. It smells very sweet, it's warm, and it's very, I would say, balmy. So it does have a very oriental feel to it. So if that's not your thing, you're not gonna like this scent. It kind of puts me in the mind of Hypnotic Poison by Dior. They're not dupes, but the same balminess, that same sweetness that you get from Hypnotic Poison is the same kind of fragrance that you're gonna get here. So if you don't like Hypnotic Poison, I'm not sure if you're gonna like this one. You may, because at least this one has a bubblegummy smell, while Dior's fragrance has more of a vanilla type scent, if that makes sense. That brings me to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any interest in any of the fragrances that I spoke about in today's video, Check the links below. All the links that I provided in the description box will lead directly to all these fragrances. Now, oh, one more thing, guys. I know I haven't been asking, but now that I'm on top of it, do me a huge favor. Go over to my Instagram, Shauna underscore J underscore. Shauna underscore J underscore. Go over to Instagram, follow me there if you want to see my scent of the day, my fragrance combinations. So I get to post random stuff over there that I just don't talk about over here on YouTube. So don't forget to follow me over on Instagram. Not to mention, every now and then I surprise y'all with a little fragrance giveaway. I love to give away fragrances because sometimes a girl, you know, have too much. Anyway, guys, that's it for me. Bye.
We'll be right back.